business, but now this right here is personal. Kingdom is my business, but now this right here is personal. Kingdom is my business, but now this right here is personal. This right here is personal. This right here is personal. Kingdom business, but now this right here is personal. Kingdom is my business, but now this right here is personal. Kingdom is my business, but now this right here is personal. This right here is personal. This right here is personal.
Yeah, I don't know if I told you I'm working on a solo album, man. Yeah, I decided to go ahead and do that.
Yo, I just got 4 followers on Twitter, man.
I put my rhymes in here, got ideas, any kind of concepts and stuff, features.
Hey, yo, Shaw, you watch that Love & Hip Hop show?
Yeah.
Swag.
I'm really shouting to the prime. I'm really,
like, straight out the rapper
like
blood.
Like my swag. Shop,
like a new candy bar. Fine, man.
Y'all a bunch of children, man.
What, man? Whatever, man. You talking to me? I was saying, when Shawty was talking crazy, it was crazy, Shawty.
You know nobody understood a word you just said. It's a pretty important book, you know what I mean?
Man, don't nobody want to hear your music, man. Play that, man. Nobody want to hear that whack garbage you writing anyway, man.
Yo, what up?
Get out of here with that, man.
Swag. Yeah, maybe tomorrow. Yeah, I don't have the time to do it.
Alright. Yeah, I'll get at you tomorrow.
Alright,
cool.
Nah,
he got it.
Alright, man.
Where's my journal?
Yo, one of these dudes.
This is a hip hop whodunit. Who's the prey? Who's being hunted? Where's my stuff? Why do they want it? Who at the table ain't being 100? Daryl is that hood brother who likes to think everything that comes out his mouth is extra deep. The kind of chief who be lying through his teeth, fake gold in his mouth so you know his talk is cheap. The kind of brother in the barbershop who never gets his hair cut cause he talks a lot. Who has the most ridiculous statements about politics, like Son Obama will play for the New York Knicks. But why would he take it? He don't like my music. So him taking the paper is pretty much useless. He been coming around for about a month now. Why would he jeopardize that trust now, man? I know he trying to change his life. Plus, he been asking questions about Christ. Well, what if it's all just a plot? Just in case my house is still everything I got. This is a hip-hop whodunit. Who's the prey? Who's being hunted? Where's my stuff? Why do they want it? Who at the table ain't being 100? Maybe he's saying he a cat from the burbs. Always quick to mention how he used to smoke herb. How him and his homies used to do work. Doing crimes and getting them dimes off their skirts. Them cats who boast all the time are them same knuckleheads who ain't never did crime. Facebook junkie, he on Twitter as we speak. Maybe he took the paper so he could use it as a leak. Living in his mom's house, internet thug. Dressing like a hipster, loudmouth punk. I don't even know why I let him up in my house. Cause everything we say just gon' end up on the south. Switching personalities every day, that kinda dude that overuses swag, and that's cray. Yeah, he's just searching for the next trend. I got my eyes on him until then. This is a hip hop whodunit. Who's the prey? Who's being hunted? Where's my stuff? Why do they want it? Who at the table ain't being 100? This is a hip hop whodunit. Who's the prey? Who's being hunted? Where's my stuff? Why do they want it? Who at the table ain't being 100? Is it my man Sean? But it couldn't be. He never did agree with me leaving reach. He been walking with the Lord for some years now. He know my strengths, my weaknesses, and fears now. I ain't ballin', I don't act Hollywood. He really knows me, so what's really good? He knows my life ain't nothing to envy. Maybe he just sick of being a friend of an MC. And he wants to shine, so he could've did it. But nah, he ain't tried to rap in a little minute. But hold up, the other day when we spoke, he said he was writing, even though it sounded like a joke. But I'm sure we all know a couple folks who know they serious, even though it seems they blowing smoke. Man, it's stupid, it ain't even worth it. Who took my paper, and what was their purpose? I guess it's the risks of trying to live missional. Open up your house to lies, fakes, criminals. I'm going from Johnny Cochran on these lies to OJ. Lay a couple hands on these guys.
I need some more though. I'll take your journal. Thanks though. Appreciate it. You see my wallet?
Your wallet? You missing your wallet?
Yeah, can't find it. But whatever.
This is DJ KB with the Antonio Johnson Show and DFW's 116 Kingdom Business. I'm here with Sho Baraka. How you doing, man?
No interviews, dog. No interviews.
No interviews. No interviews. Kind of too late for that, bro.
I'm doing pretty good. How you guys doing?
All right. We're doing good, man. You just killed the show tonight. New Year's. It's just, it's here. It's still here, and we still awake.
21-3, sir.
I can't believe it.
2013, you gotta stay clean.
Okay, bro, for the people that don't know who you are, who's Sho Baraka?
I am a young, well, not that young anymore, but I'm a...
You still young, man.
I'm a dude from, raised in California, went to college, found the Lord in college. Well, I didn't find the Lord. The Lord found me, because the Lord wasn't lost. Lord found me in college, changed my life, got me into some music and film and television, and ever since then I've just been trying to figure out how to maneuver through these avenues of music and film while being excellent in the craft, but at the same time keeping my eyes on the cross. And so that's who Sho Baraka is, man. So I'm an artisan. I love music, I love art. I love my family, I'm married, children. I have a revolutionary mindset. I love to change the black community via the gifts and skill sets that God has given me, along with the other brothers and sisters. I feel like it's time for a change in a lot of our communities. And so, man, I'm a little bit of everything, brother.
Okay.
I know I'm nothing without the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Living Trinity, that's...
You know what I'm saying?
So, what do you think you're doing with Christian hip hop? What is the impact that you're making on the community?
Ultimately, I think what I do is I think God has given me a voice, and I just try to use that voice to be true to one who I am and true to who He is. And it's not so much that I'm trying to change Christian hip hop, because I'm not trying to change a genre per se. What I'm trying to do is make music for people. I think of people. I don't think of genres. I don't think of markets. I think of people. And when I see that there are certain people that I feel who are being left out, the reality of it is that, you know, there's songs like We Could Be More that kind of like reach people, because there are songs out there that talk about marriage in a biblical way, but there are very few hip hop songs that really communicate relationships in a way that, one, is very fun and entertaining, but very true to scripture. So that's who I am, and as far as this music thing, is just trying to make music that I feel changes the hearts of people, pushes people in the right direction.
Let's talk about Shut Us Down and Get Wise. The lyrics in both of those songs are very thought-provoking, as far as if you go outside the church, they look at you a certain way. If you're inside the church and you're doing it different than a traditional way, they say that you're radical and you're doing things that are not wise. And then with Get Wise, you're talking about the things that we should do that's missional, yeah, that we don't necessarily do. And we should get smart to how society is changing and how we should adjust to those things and do more.
Get Wise is just basically a song that says that everybody talks about change, but ain't nobody living it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You got a lot of people who pontificate and philosophize about the deep things, but, man, when you evaluate their life and look at them, it's just like, man, like, what are you, in the end of the day, what is all this information and this knowledge doing for the body of Christ? What is all this information doing for your community? What is all this information doing for your household? And so everybody can just sit around and quote dead men, you know what I mean? But what are the information that these dead men giving us? How are we applying this and changing lives? So, it Shut Us Down is just talking about Matthew 16, where it's like, man, God has given us, it says, I've given you the keys, and like gates of Hades will not prevail against this, you know what I'm saying? And so, reality is like, man, the church is the means by which we are going to change the world. And nobody can stop the church from what it's doing, so nobody can shut us down. No matter if there's a lot of opposition out there that may come from the religious, there's opposition that may come from the world. But the reality is, man, apart from all that, God has given us a call.
Okay. So what message do you want to leave to people that know who you are, what you stand for, and who you're representing?
I would say, man, get yourself a Samsung. Stay away from Apple products. Because Apple is duping us, you know what I'm saying? They ain't really doing good upgrades, but they want us to believe that they upgrade and they good from, you know what I'm saying? No, it's playing. What I would say, man, ultimately is that we search the world high and low for many things. Man will kill himself to find significance. High, low, in between. But the reality of it is you'll search to the day you die. The book of Ecclesiastes just talks about how we chase after the wind. And so I think at the end of the day, the bottom line and the chief end of man is to love God, hate sin, and enjoy him all the days of his life. And so for those people who are searching for things to fill that eternal void in our heart, man, nothing's going to replace that but the Lord himself.
Okay.
And so I would say, man, just those people who are searching for significance, man, is only found in Jesus.
You went out on your own, left Reach, and you're doing your own thing. How is that going?
It's good. It's good. It's not easy, but it's good. You know what I mean? I mean, it's not it's not perfect. You know what I mean? But you make calculated risks and steps every time you do stuff like this. Like, you know, nobody makes decisions. Well, people shouldn't make a decision like that and not know, like, the possibility of what could happen. You know what I mean? So it's a faith move, man. And when you make a faith move, you realize it's trusting in the Lord. It's not by my power and my might. So that's kind of like what the situation is. You know what I mean?
Okay. Well, I'd like to thank you for sitting down and doing an interview with us. I know you're tired, man.
Thank y'all.
Long night. This is DJ. Oh, go ahead.
I'm sorry. I was just saying nope. I was just saying good stuff.
This is DJ KB with the Antonio Johnson Show and DFW's 116. How can they reach the show?
My website is lionsandliars.com. Lionsandliars.com. So any kind of information, what's going on in my life, you can get on there. On Twitter, it's AMI. Sho Baraka, so like Amisho Baraka. Mm-hmm. On Facebook, it's the same thing, Amisho Baraka, Facebook. My phone number is 911. Holler at me.
Okay.
So, that's it, dog.